the main thing that that we provide is an artificial intelligence platform to supercharge image sensor performance. And now this has many different applications, but you know, being the robotics and AI session, you know, coming up in the context of that, you know, robots need to be able to see right mm-hmm. their environment in order to understand, you know, their surroundings, and a lot of the image sensors that go onto these robots don't see very well in the dark. And one of the ways that, you know, we can go about improving how they see, and we're talking about robots, we're also talking about, you know, ADAS systems and autonomous vehicles. You know, all these things have difficulty, you know, sensing in the dark right now with traditional camera-based sensors. But there's a lot of information that's still in there that we're just not able to access with the current way that we process the raw data coming off the sensor. And so what we do is actually mimic the human brain in terms of how we interpret the raw signals that are coming in into our eyes.
So human beings are better at seeing in the dark than a self-driving car?
Yeah, exactly. Even though your retina has, you know, 5 to 10 times worse sensitivity in terms of, you know, quantum efficiency than your CMOS sensor does, you know, even on a cheap, you know, cell phone, we're able to do much better in terms of interpreting those signals and see a much clearer image.
We can connect the dots in a way
exactly.
that they can.
Exactly. Yeah. And so what we do is we take that paradigm. So the way we're able to do that is because we go through this amazing process called perceptual learning, where we're, you know, born blind, and over the first few months of our lives, we actually learn how to see. Our brain trains itself, you know, how to, again, you know, interpret these raw signals that are very, very noisy coming in from the eyes. And we do that because we have real world experiences, right? So we interact, you know, in the real world and understand the edges, the patterns, and the textures that come up over and over again. So we get incredibly efficient biological encoding, you know, of these visual features. And that's really what's missing right now in terms of how our, you know, robots and camera systems in general see the world. And so what we do is recapture that process, put it into artificial neural networks, establishing a digital brain behind the image sensor, and thus dramatically improving its capability.
So it's a big, it's cloud connected, or are all these machines going to have to sort of relearn how to see in the dark one by one?
Yeah, so to answer the first part of your question, you know, there's just too much the bandwidth that would be necessary in order to do this on the cloud. These are incredibly, kind of, you know, uncompressed raw frames coming through 30 frames a second, right? So it needs to, all the computation needs to happen on the edge locally. Each camera model, each of them have their own, you know, manufacturing processes and circuit design, which basically require a new neural network to be trained for that, you know, model. And so while there is some sort of retraining that would need to happen, it wouldn't be at the sort of individual unit level, it would be at the sensor level.
And how big of your user base do you anticipate being these robotics applications?
So right now we're actually doing a paid pilot with a, you know, sort of, you know, very large robot manufacturer. And you know, volumes aren't huge, right? Just generally in the robot space, but they're certainly sort of, you know, a great you know, application to show the importance, right, of being able to see well in visually challenging scenarios. We're also focusing a lot on the smartphone market as well as the automotive market.
Right. You can't say who that partner is?
At this point, I can't.
Okay, no. Great. Thank you so much for joining us.
Okay, great. Thank you, Brian.